Hello guys, welcome to Python training course by Software Testing Hub. So in our previous video, we discussed about one of the concept of books. That is one of the most powerful concept, that is inheritance. What are the three different types of inheritance? That is single, multi-level and multiple inheritance. So today we will discuss three more concept of book, that is method overloading, method overriding and data heading. Okay, so first of all, what is overloading? So multiple method with same name but different type of parameters or different number of parameters, then it is called method overloading. So method overloading means, so let's say I have one function, yeah, okay, I define some parameters a comma b, say function as f. Okay, then I'll write some code here, first test one. Okay, now I'll create one more function with the same name, okay, but different number of parameters. So this is called method overloading. Why it is called method overloading? Because I have defined a function with the name as name, and I'm defining the same function using the same name. I have defined this, let's say this function as alpha. Okay, I have defined this function called add, and I will accept two arguments a comma b. Then I'm creating one more function with the same name add, but it accepts three parameters. Okay, this is method overloading. But remember, method overloading is not supported in Python. Okay, that means we can create this type of functions as well, but it will not support method overloading. Okay, it will support only method overriding. Whereas some other languages like Java, C, they support both overloading and overriding, but in Python it will not support method overloading. That I will show you with an example why it not supports. So I will create one class, say overloading. Okay, so here I will define a function called product. It accepts two arguments. Okay, multiply this product into P, A into P. Then I will print P. Okay, create one more function with the same name, product A comma B comma C. Accept three arguments. Okay, I'll say P equal to A into B into C. We print P. Okay. So if I mouse over here, it says we declared a product defined above without usage. See, that means I'm redeclaring this function with the same name. Okay, but different parameters, different number of parameters. Okay, this is called method overloading. As I said, it will not support method overloading. Why? Because what happens here is in Python, I have defined this function, say product, and I have defined this function product. So whatever the latest function you define, that will be updated. Okay, now this function will no longer function. So this function product will no longer work. Only working function is product. See, and now I'll call this function product. So product 10 comma 20 comma 30. Okay, I'll execute this. 6000 it will print. That means 10 into 20 into 30 it will print. It will call this function. Okay, so now I want to call this function. It accepts only two arguments. So I'll call this function. Let's see. Product then comma 20. Okay, so let's execute this and see the result. You can see, right? The product function is missing one required position argument C. Okay, I'm calling this function because it has only two parameters A and B. So I'm passing two parameters, but it is telling it has one more argument called C, but it is not there here, but it is present here. So as I said, in Python, the latest function will get updated. So this function will not at all work. Hence, method overloading will not support in Python. But you can write like this, it's not a problem, but it will not support in Python. That's it. So in Java, same thing works in Java as well. So in Java, if you call this function, it will go to here and it will execute. And this function will go here and it will execute. So that is pure method overloading. Then one more concept of polymorphism is method overriding. So method overriding means, let's say method overriding. So in method overriding, a subclass method has the same name which is declared in the superclass method. Then it is called a method overloading. So method overloading can be achieved only you are using a inheritance. Okay, if you want to achieve method overloading, then you have to use inheritance concept. That we will see with some example. I will create one more file. Let's name it as overriding. It is almost similar to functions, but almost similar to overloading, but it uses inheritance. It has to use inheritance. I'll define a class called A. Okay. And I will define a function define. Say hi pi. Say hi boss. Say hi to my friend. Okay. And say, I am in class A. Okay, I will declare my class B and I will inherit A. Okay, I will define the same function here with same name and same num without any parameters. Say hi. Okay, I'll print. I am in class B. Okay, now I will create an object for class B. Okay, I will call say hi function. Okay, if you observe here, I have defined one class called A, and I have defined one function called say hi inside the class, and I'm printing I'm in class A. I define one more class called B and inheriting the properties of A class. Then I'm overriding the function which is present in the class A, that is say hi. If you want to override this function, then you have to use the same name, say hi. Then you can use anything here. Okay, you can write any code in here. So when we use overriding is, suppose I have one class, I have two classes. I have defined one function or some properties in one class, say class here, okay? So same function name in class B as well. But I will define some properties differently. Okay, that is how I done here. See, it is printing I'm in class A, it is printing I'm in class B. Okay, if I call this function, so let's see, it will call this function or this function. Okay, it will call this function because I'm overriding it. Okay, you can see I'm in class B. If I don't override it, I'll just comment it. Okay, now I will print it. So I have to write something. I'll say pass. See, I'm in class here. If I don't override it, it will call this function. If I override it, the latest function will be called. So this is called method overriding. And if you can observe here, Python shows the suggestions as well very beautifully. So it is subclassed by B, which means the class A is inherited by class B. And if I mouse over here, it's overridden in B. That means this function is overridden in class B. Mouse over here, overrides method in A. That means this function overrides the method which is present in A class. It is that simple. Okay, this is about method overriding. And we have one more and final concept of advanced Python, that is data hiding. So it is also a very powerful concept. So data hiding. So data hiding means making the data private so that it will not be accessible to other class members and can be accessed only within the class where it is declared. Okay, which means I'll declare some class, so I will declare some values in it. Okay, so if I want to access those values, then outside of the class or inside another class, then I have to use the inheritance, right? So I have class A and the class B. So if I want the properties of class A, I will inherit the class A into class B so that I can access. But if what if I don't want to give these values into other, say, okay, let's see with an example. Create one file, data ID. Okay, in Python we can create private variables, or you can hide the variables using a double underscore. Okay, you have to prefix the variable name with double underscore. Okay, different class, say my class. Okay, so now I'll declare one variable called num. The value as 10. Okay, now we define one function called add. Access one argument A and say sum equal to self dot num plus A. Then I'll print sum. Then I'll create an object OB equal to my class. Then I'll say OB dot add. I'll pass 20. Okay, accept one argument, passing 20. So if you observe here, I'm declaring class, my class, declare one variable num. So now I want to make this num variable as private so that it cannot be accessed outside the class, or it cannot be accessed anywhere outside the class. Okay, let me just ob dot print ob dot num. Okay, if I print this, if I execute this, see, that is, I'm calling this function 10 plus 20 is 30, and I'm accessing this variable outside of the class. So I don't want to access this variable outside the class. I comment this first. So then I have to prefix this variable with double underscore. Okay, then I have to do this double underscore here. Okay, so which means this variable num is a private num. That means we cannot access it outside the class. So let me say double underscore. Okay, we'll execute this. You only see the output. See, my class object has no attribute called double underscore num. What it is saying is, My class don't have any variable called this, but I have the variable called this, right? But it is not visible to this print statement. That's why it's saying, right? It has no attribute. So this is called data hiding. Okay. So sometimes we use data hiding because we don't want others to use my data into other in their classes. So at that time, I will define those variables which has I'll prefix those variables with a double underscore so that other people can't access it. Okay, this is about data hiding. So today we'll discuss about overloading, overriding, and data hiding, which are the major concepts of object-oriented programming language. So this is all about the advanced and object-oriented concepts of Python. Okay, this is all about everything. So then in our next classes or next video, we'll see some additional topics of Python, so additional concepts of Python. So thank you guys.